from the historic Loretto Abbey Chapel. With the kind cooperation of the Toronto Catholic District School Board, the National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents the Daily TV Mass.
Welcome to the celebration of the Daily TV Mass. I'm Father Hank Van Myl. The televising of this Mass is made possible by the contribution from two donors. The first is Mary Movrin from Etobicoke, Ontario, in memory of her husband, John Movrin, who watched the TV Mass daily when he could no longer attend Mass at his parish. The second is an anonymous donor from Westminster, California, for a special intention. Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And as we have placed ourselves before the Lord on the solemnity of the Annunciation, again we recall how weak we are and that we need God's guidance. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us say together, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And let us pray. O God, who willed that your word should take on the reality of human flesh in the womb of the Virgin Mary, grant, we pray, that we who confess our Redeemer to be God and man may merit to become partakers even in his divine nature, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord spoke to Ahaz, saying, "Ask a sign of the Lord your God. Let it be deep as Sheol or high as heaven." But Ahaz said, "I will not ask, and I will not put the Lord to the test." Then Isaiah said, "Hear then, O house of David, is it too little for you to weary mortals that you weary my God also? Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Look, the young woman is with child and shall bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel, for God is with us." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Given me an the glad news of deliverance in the great congregation. See, I have not restrained my lips, as you know, O Lord. Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will. Praise to
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favorite one. The Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I'm a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born of you will be holy and will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son, and this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren, for nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to Lord Jesus Christ.
Usually always the solemnity of the annunciation of Jesus is always in Lent, and all of a sudden we make a big switch because it's a major feast day. And actually historically it was a major feast day. Also it was the first day of the year, up till about the 16th, 17th century, depending what country we are in. And it's a great feast to celebrate the Annunciation, God incarnate coming into the world. But it's also a celebration of motherhood. Mary saying yes. I don't really fully understand. She asks questions like, "How can this be?" But she says yes, her great fiat. "I accept no matter what will happen. I don't understand, but I accept." And of course, she is something to live up to, and especially for mothers, the guiding star for mothers. And especially in this day and age, we don't celebrate motherhood enough. It is so important, the next generation to carry on the faith. Mothers carry on the faith. Just like Jesus, yes, he's God, but Jesus did not step and say as a two-year-old, you know, I'm God. No, Jesus didn't say that. But Mary gave him all the faith she had, all the mystery she understood. And of course, in that, God, because Jesus is also fully human, Jesus also had to learn like a little child and to grow up and to experience different things and to see how God spoke in his heart. Yes, he is the Son of God, he's divine, but to be fully human, he also had to learn, just like you and me. And that's why it's such a beautiful day to celebrate the vocation of motherhood. Mothers who say, yes, I accept whatever is in my womb. I accept. I don't know what it will look like in my future, how my daughter, my son will turn out, but I will do my best and I will give everything. What a beautiful day to pray with and not to fear. And when we go to the first reading of Isaiah, it is beautiful how Isaiah, he is really fearing Israel is the fall of Jerusalem is imminent. And Isaiah says, don't fear. Don't fear. And just ask for a sign. And Ahaz says, no, I can't do that. You know, I don't want to put God to the test. And so Isaiah says, therefore the Lord himself will give a sign. Look, the woman is with child, and name him Emmanuel. Emmanuel, God is with us. God is with you and me. What a beautiful foretelling of God incarnate coming into the world. And so when Jesus came in the world, we literally started the era of grace. And that's why also in days past, from the 6th century on, it was understood, it was really the first year of the calendar. How beautiful also in spring to look forward to new life. And this is the mystery in a busy world. Our world is so busy. It always has been. We're running here, we're running there, and we forget that God is at the center. That God is at the center. That everything flows from God. But a mother who gives everything to the child knows that she cannot bring up this child by herself. She knows that she needs God. She knows that she needs a community around her to help the child. And this was no different than in the time of Jesus. The village came together to help Mary along, to teach Jesus. Because yes, the parents, Mary, Joseph, were the primary teachers. But there's also the village of teachers. There was Elizabeth who taught, and so on. And it is so important, it is so overlooked in this day and age, what it takes to really bring a child in the world. What a commitment it takes to be a mother, to say, yes, I put my career on the side. It's no longer about me. It is about my child or my children. I will give everything, no matter what. Something to sit with for mothers and fathers to make that commitment in a culture which teaches us, in a culture that teaches us to say, it's all about you, it's all about me. Commitments, well, we make commitments and they are only, you know, after a few years, like a car, we'll change our commitments. A lifetime commitment like a mother makes can only come through God, just like a marriage. A marriage can only survive by the grace of God, that the people listen in their hearts and know that God has to be become before everything. We can't do it on our own. I can't do it on my own. We all need people around us of community to help us along. None of us are a God on our own, lower G God, that we can do it on our own. We need one another, but first of all, we have to realize that we need God before everything else. Amen. And so let us stand and let us say together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. And let us bring our prayers before the Lord. We pray for all those in the Daily TV Mass community who have asked to be included in our prayer intention book, especially those looking for a deeper awareness of God through their Lenten journey. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
and let us pray for all mothers, especially mothers who are struggling in their vocation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
and for these prayers and the prayers in the silence of our own hearts, we lift them up to you, Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
And the spirit and contrite heart may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquities, cleanse me of my sins. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands, praise the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, Almighty God, to accept your church's offering, so that she who is aware that her beginnings lie in the incarnation of your only begotten Son may rejoice to celebrate his mysteries on this solemnity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For the Virgin Mary heard with faith that Christ was to be born among men and for man's sake, by the overshadowing power of the Holy Spirit. Lovingly, she bore him in her immaculate womb, that the promise to the children of Israel might come about, and the hope of nations be accomplished beyond all telling. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exalt praise as we acclaim.
Blessed is he.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these guests, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis or Pope, Thomas or Bishop, the order bishops, the clergy, and the entire people you have called your own. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. And at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And may the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
Please join me now in this act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart, as though you were already there. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Permit not that I should ever be separated from you. Amen. Let us join together in this prayer to Saint Joseph. Hail, guardian of the Redeemer, spouse of the Blessed Virgin Mary. To you, God entrusted his only Son. In you, Mary placed her trust. With you, Christ became man. Blessed Joseph, to us too, show yourself a father, and guide us in the path of life. Obtain for us grace, mercy, and courage, and defend us from every evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Confirm in our minds the mysteries of the true faith, we pray, O Lord, so that confessing that he who was conceived of the Virgin Mary is true God and true man, we may, through the saving power of his resurrection, merit to attain eternal life through Christ, O Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass.
Through the Stations of the Cross, we follow in Jesus' footsteps from Pilate's palace to Calvary. To get your copy of the large print booklet, Reflections on the Way to the Cross by Father Pat Fitzpatrick, please call the NCBC at 1-888-383-6277 or visit our website to order online.